So we've identified 9 currency pairs that we might want to trade this seasonal effect on. And we've picked trade times that seemed reasonable given the sweet spot across similar assets, the requirement for strategy diversification, and some quite compelling evidence that certain trade times seem to be optimal for certain pairs. And of course, we had the benefit of hindsight to pick these sub-strategies and parameters. So looking at them, putting it all together and looking at them over that same data is of course going to look quite good, at least before we add costs. But I believe that we've constructed it in a thoughtful way. So let's have a look at the backtest of all 9 of those things put together. It looks exceptionally good, and that's not necessarily a surprise. But there's a big but coming up. We only have an average profit per trade here of 3.2 pips. That's a bit on the small side when we allow for the fact that we almost certainly won't see performance that good in live trading going forward. So we're going to expect a bit of degradation in performance on this thing. And 3.2 pips doesn't give us a huge amount of wiggle room. It's going to be absolutely fine if performance persists in our out of sample, but it's not going to give us as much space as we want if we don't. So let's, if that doesn't happen, so let's see what it looks like with some conservative trading costs modeled by Zora. Still does look very good. So the Sharpe ratio has been reduced from a ridiculous 2.6 to almost half by trading costs. So that's now Sharpe ratio 1.48, which is still spectacular. And the average profit though has dropped to 1.8 pips. So this would be absolutely fine if we got that performance in live trading, but we really need to prepare for the worst, and we need to give ourselves the best chance of making money. So what can we do? We want to get profit per trade up. What can we do? And we've got 2 main ideas. One, we could use a momentum filter to exclude trades that would be entered on large short-term momentum. So we quite often at higher frequencies or short time frames see short-term momentum effects that we can use to avoid trading when we see extreme short-term momentum. The second one, this is a pure alpha trade. You know, we're over the 24-hour period, we're long, then we're short, then we're long, then we're short. So it's very, very literally trades volatility. So, you know, with some of the pairs don't move that much, and some of the pairs go through extended periods of low volatility. And volatility clusters and is predictable, as we learned previously, especially in the risk premia stuff we looked at. So maybe we can use a volatility forecast to exclude trades that would be taken in a low volatility environment. So note here that we're erring on the side of just excluding the trades that are unlikely to be favourable. So we're not trying to exclude many trades, we're just looking to try and exclude ones on extreme momentum perhaps, or when volatility is very low. And that's what we'll be discussing in a couple of days as we start to get this strategy ready for live trading. So it looks very, very good. But we're worried we don't have much wiggle room in it. So what can we do? And we're going to look at these 2 ideas.